Now I'm going to introduce our next speaker, that is Angelo Mencarelli. He's a researcher of the computer vision and robotics of the Wageningen Marine Research Institute from the Netherlands. And he's to present a fully documented fisheries automatic discard registration in clustered environments. So Angelo, thank you very much for attending. Please go ahead.
Good morning, everybody. Of afternoon, actually, or not still, but it's morning. Can you see my presentation?
Yeah.
Perfect. Yeah. Okay. Okay. As you mentioned, I am a researcher in computer vision and robotics. I am also part of the members of the Agrofood Robotics. That is, let's say, a larger unit of researcher that cover different institutes of Wageningen. So there are more than 60 researchers that are doing the job in different institutions from plant science to marine research and livestock that work together. So Full Document Fishery is a project founded by the European Maritime and Fishery Fund. And one of the objectives of this project is the development of a 3D camera system to classify, count, estimate the weight by species of the bycatch as a result of the fishery activity. As we know, the introduction of the landing obligation obliged the fishing vessel to sort, store, and land the undersized fish of the total allowable catch. And this is a major additional task on board in fishery catching with a mixing composition of species. The full document fisheries aim to automatically register the all catches, species in their quantity, making distinction between catch over and catch under the legal minimum conservation site. The project provides the needed data and the transparency without to manually sort and the underside fish and to store it and to land it. It's our, let me say, idea to passing from the landing obligation to the registration obligation. So make a system that in principle detects the old catch, and it's not necessary to bring it at the shore. The consortium is for partners, Wageningen Marine Research, the Wageningen University, the Wageningen Plant Science, and the Fish Union Visnet. In this project, one of the purpose is the development of an automatic detection system that is able to acquire images of the discard without influence the privacy of the privacy of the fishermen, so only the discard, to classify account the different species separating the fish from the debris, to estimate the weight of the discard by species, and based on the length measurement, separate the fish above and below the minimum conservation reference sites. Here we see the 3D camera system that we developed, the prototype one, with the idea indeed to avoid to have the camera on top of the conveyor belt very high and also make the visibility of the men around the conveyor belt, but also to have a more protected environment for the camera itself, let me mean for illumination and the variance of the illumination. So what we see at the left, the digital design of the 3D model, and we mounted, and in the left side you see the inside of the 3D. And what we used is a very basic stereo camera, the Intel RealSense camera, the D435. Actually, we used the industrial version of the camera, the Framos. You see here is mounted inside of a housing for more protection, because it's the housing of the industrial is aluminium and it will not last more than a week on sea. And also we added diffuse illumination that will have give more diffuse light on the conveyor belt, and also controlled light. So this is everything to enhance the quality of the image before to start to really have, let me say, to use the software to detect the fish itself. So, and what we did also is that, we know we, with this camera, what we have in principle is, we have a sequence of matrix images, 15 images per second. Of course, what we thought is if we use the matrix image, we use just 20 lines of this image, and we reconstruct this in a kind of lens scan, we could have an infinite image in principle. And what is one of the benefits is, of course, that first of all, we have a cheap camera that make a line scan. And the second is that we have, yeah, a very large image like we want. We can cut what we want and also to recalculate the overlap between the images to track the fish to avoid the double count. But also very important is the fact that we have no perspective problem. So we have just the observation close to the optical axis of the image. And if you orientate the light in such a way, you have almost no reflection on the conveyor belt and almost all the fish. And third part, very important, you saw from the prototype that the prototype itself is very bulky. It has a large dimension and is very close to the conveyor belt. Actually, take a place of one man of the crew. With using of this technique, we can reduce really the space of the camera itself to the conveyor belt. That's the camera, I didn't mention, but the camera is placed at the end of the conveyor belt because it's counting the discard. What is the basic idea of using a stereo camera? The basic idea is that during the image acquisition, we have, of course, the color image, but also we acquire also the depth image. Using the color image or the RGB and applying an assemble of different the network, we can extrapolate or segment the fish from the debris. And the idea is that with this information, we can, from one side, count the fish, extrapolate the length, but also using the depth information, we can have more information about the volume computation, so estimate the weight in a better way. Second, in overlapping, surely if you have fish on the fish, we can extrapolate also the volume that the fish has, let's say, overlapping. So the calculation is also help to understand of large part of the overlapping what is under something else that is occluding. We mounted our system on a conveyor belt that simulates the conveyor belt of troweling working area, and we went to different fish addiction, and we get the discard from different vessels, and we separated the fish. We classified the fish manually, we weighted it, and after that we put together again in boxes, and we take acquisition of the images. And using, a classifier, we made, the first part of the detection of the algorithm of the system. And so we used only the RGB images. And this is what we get, like an example, with the classification with the YOLO V3, and for the results, this article that is still under review by the Journal of Marine Research, and here just to show we have a small. I hope that will start. Yes. Just a small demo to see how the system detects. In this case, we used also a tracking system based on the Kalman filter to avoid the double counting. And yes, this is based on the discard that we took in the fish auditions. Second part, for the weight estimation, or let's say to help the weight estimation, we also applied the depth image. So using the segmentation, the instance segmentation from, we started with the Maskers NN, and now we are with Jolacht. We selected the fish and we computated the volume, and from the volume we estimated the weight. The basic idea using Jolacht is this one. You see at the right top side, the left top side, sorry, the RGB image, the depth image, and in bottom you see the results of using Jolacht and the extrapolation of the volume. With the volume, we can indeed, in combination also with regression data from the weight, combine the information of the volume and the deep learning, and not only calculate the volume in more accurate weight, but also to estimate if something is under and how large is the percentage of the volume under the other fish. So, helps for calculating better the weight. We tested on board. Due to the COVID problem, we could not test a lot, but this year, in 2020, at the end, we put the system on board. From one side was a very good, convenient situation, because no researcher could stay on board, and the system was handled only by the crew of the vessels. So the fishermen couldn't see that the system was friendly enough to stay on board. We tested three times, two times 1 week, and one times 10 days. And we tested also for mechanical stress, but also for acquisition and for a functional test. And this is one of the preliminary results using transfer learning, actually, using the training that we did for YOLO V3 and for YOLO 8, and we applied directly to the YOLO V5. These are the data from the first test on board of the system. You still see here, for example, that in the first acquisition there were still reflections, because the orientation of the light was too close to the optical axis, that we changed the angulation, and indeed we also introduced this line scan, so there is the reflection are really reduce it. And actually, I arrive at my conclusion. Although the preliminary result of the onshore and onboard test were positive, more tests and training have to be performed the next year and a half, because we tested and we got results, but we want to test on board. And we wanted to let run the system 1 month with the embedded system directly get the results, and the real test has to be on the sea, because otherwise we still have some results that are let me say, falsed by the fact that we are in, let me say, in a protected environment. The system has to be integrated on the onboard fishery management, because the idea is not only control, but only also use the fishermen to evaluate such, using this information to discard, if they have too much discard, and if it is really valuable to have a catch in a certain area or not, is something that help indeed the management, because it has recreate more, let me say, real time, if you can say that, information directly on board. We are also, there are also other features that are very interesting. In this moment, for the point of view, like the length, like everybody was saying about really taking the length, in this moment, we are just selecting in a very rough way the length, not because we are not calculating that, it's because it was not required in this specification, and because also the discard is already manually selected. But this is a part of the, let me say, of the second generation. And the same, the system can be used to semi-automatize or automatize the work process, reducing the time that the live discard remain off of the water. And that is one of the most important also result that the real world would like to achieve. And with this, I conclude my presentation. Here are the contacts of the different project leader of the different groups. And thank you very much for your attention.
SeaCaptor, monitorización electrónica para una mejor gestión.